everyone, welcome back to Fire Emblem Heroes. So once again we are back with a new showcase. In this case it is Bernadetta. She's part of the Black Eagles Edelgard House and is considered a shut-in in the world of Fire Emblem Heroes 3 Houses. So she's also a really good unit that I managed to get in one of the recent gacha that I uploaded in the channel. So I thought to myself, why not make another Fire Emblem 3 Houses showcase? We are nearly with all the units from the game, so as soon as I get more units from Three Houses, I will do a showcase on them. But this time, all the focus will be on Bernadetta. So this week we have her, then we will probably have a Resplendent Arm, if I manage to figure out how to do a Desert build on him. And after that we have the new Gacha plus the new Forging Bonds. We will see if I want to pull on the Gacha. I will let you know of course by making a video on it or not. Otherwise it will be Forging Bonds all day as usual. So the focus today, however, is on Bernadetta, so let's go and check out her summoning dialogue, level 40 dialogue, art, etc. before going into the build showcase, where I will show you the builds that I managed to build for her. As usual, hopefully you enjoy the video, and I will see you later. Okay, here we are back with Bernie, which is her nickname in the game, and we will check out her stats before moving into the three builds that I made, the base build, an offensive and a defensive build. Since she's a fairly solid unit without any need for modification, we only get two builds. Usually when we do three builds it's because I see something interesting that you could do with this unit. In this case I feel like you get her, you use her skills, it is already ready to work, which is true for most of the recent units that we got. So Bernie is also featured in a future Forging Bonds rerun that will come in November, I think it was announced today, which if I don't remember wrong is the Harmony Amid Chaos banner, which also features Dissidia, one of the units that I pulled the most for in this game and I never managed to get her. Luckily I got the Brave version. But let's not waste any more time, let's check out her stat. So, she has an average on the low side amount of HP, which kinda helps her abilities actually, so it is actually good. You don't want to get a plus HP on her boons. She has 52 attack, which is an asset, which is actually really nice, because it is the best asset you will get for her. Speed is a flaw, which is bad, because you want a plus in attack or speed and then get a minus on HP or I think rest should be good. So speed is actually on the average low side as well, otherwise it would have been really decent since she actually has a really solid offensive stat line. We have average on the low side defense and average rest. So her stat line is that of a cavalry bow unit, so as you can tell, she trades some stats for the extra movement that she gets. However, she has a really high attack stat that makes her a competitive unit in most PvP scenarios, and also some PvE maps she works really good as well. But let's check out her base skill set before making a judgment on that. However, I wanted to say that since Bernadetta is a rather new unit, her stat line won't matter as much, so you can also try to use her at plus 0. However, if you get her to plus 1, it will be actually amazing. She competes a little bit with Claude since they fit similar roles. Since Claude is flying, she is cavalry, but Claude has a lot more going for him. So I actually suggest that if you have already freed Claude, just use him and leave Bernadetta either for fodder or for some use if you like I do. Okay, so the base set, let's check out her weapon, which is actually a ton of text that I will try to sum up for you in a few words. So, effective against flying, as usual, on every bow, she gets attack plus 3, which helps a lot, as I told you earlier. And then, she has an effect at the start of combat. If she has penalty, which is a debuff effect that triggers during your next action, so your next attack or your next movement, she gets something, or if her HP is minus 100. So if you get penalty, which is this effect, is this debuff effect, or if you get less than 100 HP on Bernadetta, you trigger attack and speed plus 5 during combat, and if you initiate combat, you can make a follow-up attack before the fog and counter-attack, which, as you can tell, is really good, because with 52 attack, you most likely will defeat the enemy. So, how do you trigger this bow, however? You can see that the two conditions are rather hard to pull, because you need penalty, which is something that can only be triggered by the enemy, or you need less than 100 HP. The idea that the devs gave for this build was to give her attack and speed push 4, which is an ability that we have seen a lot of times in different heroes, and now, once again, it is back for Bernadetta. So, if she has more than 25% HP, she gets attack and speed plus 7, but she gets inflicted 5 damage. This really helps. Why? So you attack, most of the time the enemy won't be able to attack back because it is melee, for example, and you already trigger your weapon. If you pair it up with a dancer, this can be really really nice. Why? You dance, then you get a double attack plus probably a special, and you also have the other skill that she packs. So let's check out her other skill, Lull Speed Death 3. You inflict speed and death minus 3 on foe, and you neutralize their bonus to speed and death during combat. So this helps in two ways. First, you will destroy melee units, or in most cases, mage units, since they are the units that usually have low death. If they are infantry, most of the time it is true. For other bow, for other dragons, etc., you might find some trouble. However, you will reduce also their speed. So most of the time, even if you attack for the first time and don't trigger Persecution Bow, you will be able to destroy them thanks to this B-skill ability. Which is why her base set is really solid. Those three abilities make up for anything that you will try on her, especially as an offensive unit. For C, we have Close Guard 3, a rather supportive ability that I suggest that you replace for an offensive build, which I will show you with what I saw was good, but with Claude and Attack and Speed Rhyme 3, you can tell which is the best ability. Sorry, that's for flying, it's not for cavalry. So, in this case, we have Close Guard. I will show you another ability that I value to be rather good. And then Heavy Blade 3, because with such high attack, it makes sense to help trigger a special. So she doesn't come with a special, however I suggest Noontime. Why? So you attack, you trigger Noontime, you heal back to full, which happens after you trigger the Persecution Bow double attack, and then you trigger attack and speed push 4. So with this Noontime, you will be never be able to be at full HP. However, you also will be never able to be at less than 25 HP. Why? Because you always heal, you always take damage, but you always kill the enemy. This is a really cool idea that I had, and it actually works. So the base build, I feel like, is the best build you can use on her. Just change the C ability, which we'll check out in a second. And I really recommend that you use her and check it out, because I really like how she is built with this 3 ability mechanic that she has. Ok, next build. Offensive. So, most of the ability is the same, however we took a turn for the offensive playstyle, which means player phase, which means that most abilities that trigger defensive and other type of stuff, I replace them, such as the special, such as the close guard, such as the Noontime. And we got Moonbow, as usual, one of the best offensive abilities. Savage Blow 3. So, I'm not actually a fan of Savage Blow 3, but then I thought to myself, she's a cavalry unit, so most of the time she's the first to attack, which means that you will be able to trigger Savage Blow 3 on all the enemy units since they are still in formation. This actually makes for a great play since you deal a ton of damage, and in some cases you also will help your other units to destroy the enemy. You can replace this with other abilities such as a buffing synergy ability for only cavalry units or other stuff, but I feel like Savage Blow 3 for an offensive playstyle fits better. And then Swift Sparrow 2, because it makes sense to have more attack and speed for her. Overall, this is an improvement on the base build, however I feel like the mechanic within Noontime and the blade on the Seal helps a lot to cover her weakness of low HP. So make sure to decide whenever you want to go for more offense or for more sustainability with the base build. Last build, we got the enemy face build. That is actually a huge change from the base build, mostly because I took a turn for the enemy face. Why? She actually has a really good mobility idea, since she can trigger her persecution bow even if she is in enemy face. However, the only effect that will trigger is the more attack and speed. So, what's the idea here? You can kill most ranged unit with these mages, colored bows, colorless bows, etc. You decide. How do you do this? So, Fury 3 is the cornerstone of this build, or Fury 4 if you can upgrade it. Since it does the same as attack and speed push, but instead of getting more attack and speed, you get also DPS, you end up with a ton more defensive stackline. Triggered especially with Vantage 3, which should trigger most of the time with the combo Fury 3 and Noontime, you will be able to also deal with an enemy phase where you attack first, you deal more damage thanks to this combo, and most of the time you will heal up and also be able to destroy the enemy. So, this can be improved, of course, you can replace the Close Guard with something that makes a little more defensive or offensive playstyle, and also the Seal, if you want for less healing, you will go for a stance, for example, attack and death stance if you aim to destroy bows, or attack and rest stance if you aim to destroy mages. I'm not particularly a fan of this build since she doesn't have amazing defensive stats, but we will see it in play later and see if it is justified to use. As I said earlier, the two builds that I will try are enemy phase and probably offensive since it is a small upgrade on base. And as usual, stay tuned for the gameplay showcase which will come after this segment. Before we say our goodbyes, I just wanted to tell you guys that if I don't manage to do the Resplendent Helm showcase because I am still trying to find a good build for him, since like Eriga, he needs to replace all his skill except his weapon, I will most likely do a build on a hero that I already have. I will check out my Varrax, see a hero that I have built in times past, and do it on them. So today and probably Thursday, if not, then we will see each other on Friday and do all the basically, Friday will be the Fire Emblem Hero Stay since we get all the Forging Bonds and stuff. Hopefully I will see you then. Remember to leave a like and a sub to this video if you want to support the channel and see more showcases in the future. Hopefully you enjoyed this one. Let me know in the comments your own builds for Bernie and other trivia of interesting stuff that you have about there. And hopefully you stay tuned for the gameplay showcase which is next. This is Hunter Lodge and enjoy the gameplay showcase.
If I have to. Sun's up. Okay. Ernie is sick of fighting.
The choice is clear.
I will be going.
What now?
Forward.
Where?
Oh, but I... Oh,
how lovely.
to? So far. What now? Okay. Sun's up.
How lovely.
If I have to.
Tread carefully.
Yes.
If I have to...